It shares many characteristics with other non-harmful weeds, but it's one of the most toxic plants in North America.
Yeah, it sure is. News 5's Brian Hamrick shows you what poison hemlock looks like and why it's closer to your kids than you ever imagined.
In this day and age, a lot of people are concerned about who's living in their community. Well, a lot of people don't realize that they're living right next door to a killer, one that looks like this.
It's one of the most poisonous plants in America, really.
This is the mugshot of a serial killer, aka poison hemlock. What's disturbing is that it's lurking in local neighborhoods, more prevalent than anyone can remember, and just as pretty as ever.
If kids were going to go out there and pick flowers, that'd be one of the first ones they'd pick.
Oh, probably. My son goes out there and picks them.
It's right next to Aaron Lestarza's house. He's like most who had no idea.
Did it surprise you that this was a deadly,
yeah,
poisonous plant?
Oh, yeah. I just thought it was weeds.
And your kids go through here?
My oldest son.
Easy to find about everywhere, even here at the Boone County Arboretum. Extension agent, Dr. Mike Clare.
You've been hearing from farmers that this is more prevalent here.
Yes, we have had a lot of reports. Farmers seeing a lot more of the poison hemlock this year. Probably because of the drought last year.
It looks like Queen Anne's lace, but here's the telltale sign of poison hemlock.
The Queen Anne's lace is a green stem, very hairy, all the way up and down the stem. The stem on the poison hemlock is purple, or purplish spots or streaks on it.
Recognizing it is the first step to avoiding hemlock, the same plant that killed Socrates. While we're used to killing weeds, we're not too comfortable with things the other way around.
And experts say the best way to get rid of the hemlock is to dig it up from the roots while you're wearing gloves. Brian Hamrick, News 5, where the news comes first.